So the first thing I'll share with you is our Barca ecosystem. So the Barca is a fictional brand we built here at Coveo to showcase the product. This website here is running on Adobe AEM. The important part to notice is that all these components you see, so we have a giant search box, we have the results set at the bottom with facets. This is all JavaScript-based framework called Atomic. It's also available in TypeScript with Headless. This is deployable across all types of interfaces. So we have it integrated in many CRM, but it's also on different CMS. So we have Sitecore, we have Adobe, and we're also compatible with everything out there. So this kind of interface is easily reproducible no matter where you are. So without further ado, the first thing we want to do here is to click the search box and start doing a query. What is Barca? So the first thing you'll notice is at the top, we're going to have that generative component that's going to start explaining what's in the results below. It's important to notice that the query will first retrieve the results, and based on the best passages of information from the best results, we're able to send it to an LLM and at this point generate a summary. There is a few features I want to highlight here. First off, traceability of information. This information and everything that has been done for the generative part is viewable here through citation. So each document has a little part of text that has been extracted and has been used to generate this specific answer here. Let's continue just to show the depth of the feature of a full platform like Coveo. So when you start typing something, you get that query suggestion, which is powered by previous users that got successful queries working on the system. So really a type ahead experience like you would have at Google. And then here, the generative components, all the different sets. We also offer something a little bit different. So if you switch to smart snippets here, you'll see something different. It's another type of response that we do that is actually authored. So for specific questions, if you are in a highly standardized industry, or if you need to provide like answers that are regulated, you can also decide to use a different approach, which will give you a semantic search capability. But instead of generating an answer, you can select exactly the text you want, which is also very interesting. This comes with people also ask questions, which will let you see other documents that are possible within the ecosystem that you guys have. If we go down here and click on one of these pages, you'll see at the bottom, this is a regular page that has been authored by Brian here. And at the bottom, we are also showcasing some recommendation. Why I'm talking about recommendation? We strongly believe that all these features together create a unified experience that makes the user more engaging with your CMS. So you're going to have recommendation, the query suggestion, the generation, and all these experiences create a very, very interactive experience that is personalized based on the different CMS personalization engine you have. So if you're using Optimizely or Adobe Target, you can really have these profiles injected here so the overall experience gets personalized. I'll go now and show you a different experience. So this is really like a website, informational website that has a lot of different features, but then let's go in something a little bit more live. So the first implementation we've done with GenAI was docs.coveo.com. This is our own internal documentation. The reason why I want to show you this interface is that we're going to show the back end after, show you how it's it is built. One first thing I want to show is the feedback loop I was talking about at the beginning. So now that we have a generative experience, people started to realize that, oh, this interface is intelligent. It starts to respond to better questions. So they started to get more generous with their time and their keywords. So you see here, if I'm typing how, I'm getting longer questions. These weren't there if you would go on the website 1 year ago. So really that the feature, the generative feature changed the way the users are interacting with the system, and the feedback loop takes it back and gives you actually better suggestion for the future. So let's go here with explain how this Coveo uses permissions, which is based on security. This here is a more advanced version of the component where you have here show more to avoid taking too much real estate on screen. It also has markup. So you can see that we have bold, we can have different type of like code highlighting and these kinds of features. So here, very interestingly, it's going to explain to you if you need like SharePoint or Salesforce, this is how you do it. All the citations are pointing to the documents. What I find very interesting is the RAG approach here, and a demonstration would be to click on something like Sitecore CMS. So if you select that filter, we're going to change the document at the bottom to now explain how it works with Coveo and Sitecore and websites. And this will basically change the answer. You can also see the interesting speed we have, which is very important in my opinion. This kind of experience and the user, I'd say expectation on the website is things go fast. That's how we, that's how internet works. So having this kind of reactive implementation really helps a lot. So to build something like this, if you have a mature search platform, the only thing you need to do is to log in your Coveo administration console. Once you're inside your administration console, the first thing we're going to ask you to do is to add some content. You can see here a bunch of different content we have. Like explained in the architecture slide, we have a list, a very long list of connectors. So no matter if your content is in SharePoint, ServiceNow, SAP, Salesforce, or Sitecore, we have connectors that can grab that content and bring it to Coveo Cloud. Most of them are don't need any configuration. It's actually just point and click UI. You're going to enter your user. You're going to select which part of that platform you want to index, and we'll bring that content in Coveo. Once you have the content in Coveo, the next logical step is to build a machine learning model. So here, you're going to have a set of different machine learning models. Since today we're talking about generative AI, I'll focus on this one. But please note, we have almost like 11 or 15 different models. Semantic encoder is one of them that is really required, we think, to have a good experience. But let's focus on generative experience. So we click on it, we're going to have a quick UI that's going to tell you what's going to happen, how your search interface will be modified. And at this point, we'll ask you to select your content. This is the kind of thing that for a developer or for an engineer, it saves a lot of time to be able to grab the content, chunk it, and also pre-select it so a specific interface has access to a specific part of the content. Saves a lot of time. So here, for instance, let's go and select the Coveo documentation website. You'll see that I'm right off the bat, I'm able to evaluate how many items are there. Interestingly, we are losing a little bit of documents, and that's because some part of the documentation is written in French. You may have noticed my slight accent. So we are here, a French company from Canada, and then there is a few documents and a few parts of the website that we decided to keep in French. Right now, we are only using English for the generative approach. However, French, German, and a few other languages support will come later this year. Another good reason to buy versus build. We are evolving and making this whole thing better as we are going. Interestingly, you can also be more specific. So right now I took the whole website source, but you could have filters and select some specific part so using metadata, for instance. So you can select specific metadata and scope it down. Once it's done, the only thing you need to do is to proceed. So actually you build your model, CMS wire, and then you start the build process. So at this point, it's going to start building, and it says several hours, but for the data set that I selected, it's going to be in a few minutes. And then we're going to have the model ready to associate to a search interface. At this point, it's going to start generating answers. Why are we so in love with that platform and the fact that the platform can serve multiple experiences? Once you have your content and you have your traffic and your ML build, you can reuse it across multiple interfaces. So this experience that you see here, how to use permissions, it's also available in our support line. So if you start creating a case at Coveo, so with a support ticket, you're gonna have deflection. So we'll read your case and we'll start generating answers based on the content. Obviously, we'll use the same content, so public content, but also internal cases and KBs and things that are not publicly available necessarily. Also, we decided to use a feature called in-product experience. And this feature is basically a widget that you can drag and drop all over the place. So here on the platform, you have that little question mark sign. And if you click on it, you're going to see here a condensed search interface. It looks a little bit like a chatbot, but a better version if you ask me. And this one is contextualized right away with what you're doing. So here I'm in the model section of the platform. First thing it's gonna ask you is create or update a config of a model, or if you wanna build RGA, very popular these days for us. So those are the default generation. But if you ask something like, what is a query pipeline? You're gonna have that full generative experience that you saw on the website, also available here. So the same documents, the same machine learning models can be deployed across multiple interfaces. And this is where you gain like an economy of scale of having these documents and these experiences, and you can reuse part of the content, you can reuse behavioral information you gathered on your website. So you see here, we have all those users looking for to do a lot of different things. So they're leaving traces. We can reuse that content over here. So you're gonna have like a bunch of different suggestions that's gonna appear as well.